Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. On this SGI graph from the previous time frame, we see clustering of 6 magnitude earthquakes. The first minimal clustering occurred on the 25th and 26th, following the critical geometry that I emphasized in the previous update. It was a 6.3 at Vanuatu and also a 6.6 at Tonga. And mind you, it may not look like much, but that 6.6 was the strongest earthquake since 5 April. And that tells you something about the planetary geometry that preceded this stronger seismic activity. 5.9 at Singwele, Indonesia, happened on the 28th, and that was the time of some planetary conjunctions, not too critical. And then we had another cluster, a stronger cluster of earthquakes, 5.6 and 2 magnitude 6.2 earthquakes, and that followed on a convergence of critical planetary geometry on the 30th and the 31st of May. And we shared that planetary geometry actually in the social media and also on the website. It's very worthwhile to follow these updates. As you can see here in the solar system, we had 2 planetary conjunctions, 1 involving Earth, 2 involving Mercury, and also this right angle geometry with Venus. And that is very important because right angle geometry of Venus with specific planets, that tends to be an earthquake trigger. Venus doesn't like right angle geometry. And that is the seismic activity that we had. So let's have a look at the next time frame up until June 11th. We're going to have critical geometry on the 4th, that's tomorrow, 2 planetary conjunctions involving Earth. And the first is Earth, Mercury, Jupiter. That happens at 10:18 UTC tomorrow in the morning. And then Venus, Sun, Earth. So we have 2 planetary conjunctions involving Earth. That's why we see this high blue peak that represents the Earth. And also 2 planetary conjunctions, 1 involving Mercury, the other involving Venus. And that means we have to be on high alert. There is the potential for a really big earthquake. And if we look at the solar system, we see this planetary geometry, Earth, Sun and Venus in a conjunction, and Earth, Mercury, Jupiter. And that combination, there is less than 5 hours in between, that is critical. We also see 2 lunar conjunctions coming up, one with Uranus and the other with Jupiter. And then the moon will be between the Earth and the Sun, and we know that it's a new moon. And that happens, if we look back at the SGI graph, that happens on the 6th. Now, if we take into consideration this high peak on the 4th, when is the most likely time frame for the larger seismic activity that we anticipate? It's a bit difficult to estimate because we have these lunar peaks following the planetary peak. So my estimate would be that 6, 7, 8 June is the most critical window, probably. And that's because of the lunar conjunctions on 5 and 6 June. And that follows on the planetary peak on the 4th. And again, there could be a big shake. It could go well into the 7 magnitude range because of the involvement of Mercury and Venus at the same time. If you look at the second half of this time frame, we see critical geometry, especially right angle geometry involving Venus and Mercury. That happens on 7, on 8 June, and also on the 10th. And in between, we have 2 planetary conjunctions, that's Sun, Mercury, Uranus on the 9th, and also Sun, Mercury, Jupiter. Those planetary conjunctions on itself, they are not too critical. They can trigger some increased seismic activity approaching magnitude 6, but the combination with the right angle geometry makes it more critical. So we're likely to see increased seismic activity above stronger earthquakes above average in the second half of this time frame up until the 11th and also following the 11th, and I will cover that of course in the next update. So always check out the website for the latest updates, especially atmospheric anomalies. They can be a real indicator of potential regions where larger seismic activity may occur. We share it on the website and also in the social media. Be sure to check that out. So stay safe and until next time.